hi everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions once again. I'm going to keep on working on Lars here. I know several of you have been waiting on the next video, so I figure we'd go ahead and shoot it tonight and get moving. As you can see, I've already base coated his cloak. I just kind of wanted to see, get sort of a better idea of how he's going to look once he's completely done. I'm kind of coming in right now working on the pants just a little bit. What I'm using here is a combination of Vallejo Model Color Ivory and just a spot, I'm sorry, Vallejo Model Color English Uniform and just a spot of black. And it's giving me this real nice deep brown color. And I'll come in and I'll highlight this, starting off with English Uniform, and then add a little ivory to the English Uniform, and that'll probably be it, because the majority of his pants are going to be in a fairly deep shadow since his body is covering most of the pants. The only part that's going to be kind of in a highlight is going to be this area over in here, and then maybe the tip of the knee on this side. This side's pretty much going to be all in shadow. But this is a really fun model, though. I'm quite surprised at the difference in the way the model looked on the website versus how it actually turned out once I got it. Much sharper looking model in real life than it is on the website. On the fantasization.com website, they actually inked the model with black ink to help define some of the crevices and the cracks and all that kind of stuff, and that can work well if done properly, but it doesn't look like they did it the correct way. And a lot of times you're better off, if you're showing an unpainted miniature, you're better off priming it with a nice, either very light white or a very kind of dull gray primer, and just putting a little bit of lighting on it, and that will give you a really nice shadow effect for an unpainted miniature. But they did not do that, and so it looks a little funky on the website, but I'll be honest with you guys, the minis, both of the two that I got, are very nice, and I'm pleasantly surprised with them, but they look really, really good. Looking forward to getting to the other guy, too, which we will do here very soon. I'm going to try and finish this guy up, hopefully before the weekend. It kind of depends. I've got to get both of them done before the end of the contest, and the end of the contest is at the end of the month. So hopefully we'll be done pretty soon. I need you guys to do me a favor. It won't be anytime soon, but I had mentioned a while back that a company called Taban Miniatures is holding a contest, and their contest basically runs like this. If you can put a miniature on Cool Mini or Not that they manufacture, and your miniature has an average score of 8 or better, then you get a prize, all right? And the prize is something along the lines of, you know, a fairly large sum of euros in merchandise that they make, okay? Now, I don't know how many of you guys are on Cool Mini or Not. I have not put anything on Cool Mini or Not in probably 4 or 5 years. And the reason I haven't put anything up there is because it's very difficult to get anything above a 7 unless you're a well-known painter, all right? And so I'm going to start putting stuff back up there, if anything, just for advertising purposes, but I think my stuff now would actually score a lot higher than it has in the past. But if you guys could help me out when that contest takes place, I would really appreciate it if I perhaps put a link to the Cool Mini or Not webpage that has that particular miniature on it, if y'all would vote like 9 or 10, if you think it deserves that. If you don't think it deserves that, you know, you can vote whatever you want to. But just as a way to help out with the contest. But, you know, I can understand if you don't want to do that. That's cool. And in some ways, I would actually prefer just to take it straight out. But at the same time, the odds of really anyone not well known scoring that high in their contest is going to be pretty slim, and so I'm beginning to wonder if they're even going to have a winner at all, just because it's so difficult to get. I've got a couple. I think my highest rated miniature on there was like a 7.1, and I had to just fight to get that. But you know, there's a lot of people up there who've got 9.6, 9.7, but the miniatures they turn out are just unbelievable. So, just be aware, guys, especially you new painters out there, if you put something up on Cool Mini or not, and it doesn't get rated higher than like a 5, don't get discouraged. That's pretty much where everybody ranks in that website. If you're not like, if you don't do this like all day, every day, and it's like your life, then that's where you end up. And, you know, there's nothing wrong with that. Good old water. Man, nothing like it, I tell you. I stopped drinking soda a long time ago. Never did drink alcohol, but man, soda, I tell you. When you switch over completely from soda to water, you'd be amazed at how much more energy you have. That sugar not dragging you down, oh man. Just unbelievable. Alright, mixing in a little more ivory to my mixture here. There we are. And I think this is going to be my final highlight on the pants. I'm not really taking a whole lot of time on this miniature. It's not... I'd like to win the contest, but it's not absolutely critical. If I do, I hope I do. That'd be cool, because they said if you win, they'll use your pictures in advertising, but they'll give you credit for it. So, that'd be nice. Plus, you get a couple of products from Rusted Heroes, which is nice as well. It's always good to have a few extra minis laying around. Not that I don't have, like... Oh, if I had to take a wild stab at what I'm looking at behind me. I've probably got on the order of 3, maybe 4,000 unpainted figures. Mostly pewter. So, it's not like I'll be getting anything anytime soon. But, it's always good to have a few extras laying around. Alright, I'm going to call his pants done for right now. So, not bad. Not stellar, but not bad at all. I'm going to put one little highlight right here, just because I think it looks funny without it. Right here. Okay, there we are. Okay, now, I need to kind of repaint his chainmail here just a little bit, but I'll do that in a minute. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up and work on his... Stop falling over. His face, there's not much of it, so I'm not going to do a huge highlight or anything. In fact, I may not even do a highlight. I'm going to try this color out right here. I've never used let me rephrase that. It's rare that I use just a straight flesh color right out of the jar, but I'm going to try this medium flesh from Vallejo Model Color and just see what it looks like. Most flesh colors right out of the jar are way too orange or way too pink, and I can tell you right now this one's way too orange. You see that? There is no way, I don't care who you are, nobody has flesh that looks like that. It's just too orange. I mean, you don't see that kind of flesh anywhere. Alright, so that means I have to mix up my flesh color again. Alright, so give me a couple seconds, guys, and I'll mix up my normal flesh color. And we'll go from there. Alright, 1, 2 drops.